like our oppressors, the people who oppose us, the people on the right who want to label the queer community or label concepts of gender fluidity and transitioning, want to demonize us for all of this stuff. And especially the people who want to say that, like, young people don't know who enough who they are enough to make decisions about their transitions and stuff. And so they use terms like this is a trend. They use terms like people are confused. And I think what you were mentioning is when we live in a rigid world where it's all a dichotomy, where it's all a binary, like maybe these people weren't confused, but because these were their two options, they had to pick one. And maybe sometimes they wish they could still go back and forth, like young people are experiencing today. And I just remember this conversation I had with Ben de la Creme, where I was like, there are aspects of gender revolution that feel like a trend. There are, like when so many people are starting to embrace it, it's hard not to feel like, do all of these people feel this way, or is there an aspect of it that it's a trend? And Dayla said to me, if it's a trend, what a great fucking trend. Like, think of the other trends. Think of like, think of, like I remember like the late 90s, early 2000s, just so many trends that were destructive, toxic masculinity being enforced constantly. I think of all the destructive trends, and this is a trend that's about liberation and revolution. And then that was like a handful of years ago that we had that conversation. And now I'm like, I don't think it is a trend. I think that just almost everyone would probably, if they had their minds open to it, if they grew up somewhere with families and support units and communities that allowed them to think these complex thoughts, almost everyone would find that they do not lie rigidly in a one or the other. They could identify things in their life like, oh, this aspect of me might be a little more femme, while this aspect of me is more butch, and both can exist inside of me, and I don't have to have any kind of shame or force myself to fit into any kind of box. And so, I'm sure there's like a handful of just truly like I'm a man and I'm only a man, and hopefully I never meet them.
Well, I will say on Drag Race when God Mick was talking one time about yes, I have transitioned and I'm doing drag. Not every person transitions to be Ken and to be Barbie. Do you know what I mean? Like you don't have to choose in your transition to be all the end of one spectrum or all the end of another. And I thought that was so enlightening. When I heard that, I sort of understood so much more about it because, like I say, I'm an actor. I'm very comfortable being a man. That's who I am. I'm an actor. So I have sometimes needed to understand better, and just want to understand. And so I thought that was amazing. Like you don't have to be one or the other. Like you can be, it's totally in between. And I just love that's, one of the greatest things. Not everything do I like about modern times, but that's one of the things I approve of.